Real quick, I want to thank this video sponsor, which is Keeps.
I did my first CNC project back in August of 2015. It has been 6 years exactly, and I have gone from one hobbyist machine to a crazy impressive lineup of four professional machines. Come into my commercial shop called The Woodshed and let me give you a tour of my CNC business. In case you're not familiar with how a CNC works, especially if you have multiple machines, let me take you through the process on loading them up, running them, and then repeating the process, and then I'll get into more details about the overall business of it. I primarily use these two machines for my template making business, and then this one for more detailed or elaborate jobs. So first thing in the morning, all of the machines start up. At every single machine, they each have their own individual computer. Jacob has designed and put together some plywood furniture, actually cut out on the CNC in order to house a computer used for that specific machine. The ShopSaver unit actually comes with its own pedestal, so we didn't have to create anything special for that one. When loading up the CNC machine, the vast majority of what I'm using these machines for is quarter-inch MDF. It's a little bit thinner of material, meaning that if I'm not using a vacuum bed, which these two machines don't have a vacuum, that means that it needs a lot of hold downs to hold the sheet nice and flat so that you'll get a nice consistent cut throughout the entire sheet. Jacob has come up with these very savvy, unique hold downs for these machines. And so what we do is use an electric screwdriver to go through and tighten down on every single one. It has a built-in torque setting that won't allow you to over-tighten, and it drastically speeds up this process. Then we use two quick squeeze clamps for the middle of each end. Whenever we use thicker material, we don't have to use as many hold downs as this quarter inch requires. Next, we can run the file, and then you can see both of the carriages start coming this way. Once the full sheet is ran, now I can pull the material off of it. A while back, I actually bought a sitting standing desk, and Jacob salvaged it from my workshop because I never bothered to take it out of the box and put it together. And he turned it into a raising and lowering workbench for the use of this, so that you can raise it up to a height needed to where you can just pull it up to the CNC, drag the material off, go to the next one, drag it off, and then as the sheets pile up, you can raise or lower it so that the height is always where you need it to be. Now at this point, all of these parts need to be popped out so that they can start being processed. We have tried several things over the years, and kind of a method that we've refined is just using brute force, throwing in a piece of wood in order to pick it up, and then using some sort of tool in order to bump out each and every part. It breaks through those thin tabs without breaking the part. By the way, if you're not familiar, a tab is a small piece of material that's left behind whenever you're doing the actual profile cut that will hold the piece to the material that you're cutting. That way it just doesn't just get flown across the shop. Tabs are mostly necessary whenever you're running machines that don't have a vacuum bed. They're really great for making sure that your parts don't go flying. However, once the parts are broken out of the waste material, now that waste material gets thrown over into the waste bin, and then all of the parts get taken over to a shelving unit in order to get detabbed. The detabbing station is simply a router table. I'm personally using the Triton Work Center with their router mounted underneath. I'm using a vacuum hooked up to it in order to try to maintain good dust control. Then for a bit, I'm using something called a panel pilot flush trim bit. It's slightly different because it doesn't have a bearing like a traditional flush trim bit, which makes it far easier to work on thinner pieces of material. I think that's why they call it a panel pilot flush trim bit. As you can see, you can very quickly get into a groove here and just fly through all of this. Once it's all detabbed, then it gets set over into the rack. And our personal system is to create a master of everything because we do a lot of templates. By the way, if you want woodworking templates, you know where to go. The way that we distinguish them is by painting them blue and then engraving in what that part number SKU is, the name of it. So then whenever we detab them, it's just a matter of finding that master and then piling it underneath it. This is also our quick reference on which part we need to cut next. Now going back to the CNC machines, the beds need to be vacuumed off, which we just keep a separate vacuum underneath, pull it out, it can reach both units, and then we rinse and repeat the process. Go back to the material rack, pull in new material, tighten down on all the hold downs, and then run the next part. The masters are also really good at, these are the originals, and so every part from here on out should look like these. And so it's really a quick reference. Should things start looking different, that we need to go back and either look at the file or look at the machine and see where it's gotten off. Right now, this is our inventory system. It has taken me a lot of trial and error to figure out how to ship out templates without them getting damaged into the mail. Personal process is to use some bubble wrap and also stacking the MDF in order to use the material in order to create some rigidity in the packaging. Using this method has allowed me to nix the box and instead use a poly mailer, which is just like a kind of a plastic bag that comes in different lengths and sizes. At this point, it gets sent over to my mom, who is, of course, the shipping department. And then whenever you guys place an order, she sticks a label on it, and then it gets sent out into the mail. So I did this process by myself for a solid year with the help of my mom. She's always been the shipping department. Then in 2020, I hired Jake, and he very quickly took over the CNC work. And then since then, I've hired Cindy, Terry, David. Yeah, you, Justin. But you don't ship packages. Do you want to ship packages? We need another hand. With the help of my crew, I have now been able to take this from a single machine, which, by the way, the Laguna is still in my personal shop and probably will remain for the foreseeable future, but we can still use it. So now in what year are we in? 2021. Woo, where is the time gone? Now in the year 2021, I have 6 people running 4 machines, and it's incredible. I wanted to show you the detailed steps that it takes to run the machine, but now let me show you the entire shop with all of us at our stations. So I get asked the question quite often, how did I get to this position? Let me go back to the beginning and kind of explain what my aim is and my transition here. So back in 2019, whenever I got my Laguna and I really started understanding the full capability of what a 4x8 robot could be and doing for me, I started thinking, I want to create a business that lives outside of me creating content. Because what happens one of these days whenever you guys don't want to watch my videos, or maybe I can't or don't want to be making videos anymore? I want to have something that still involves me in the making world without having to follow one path. And so I started seeing the possibilities on maybe I could be creating an additional revenue stream now and then possibly a future career, right? And so the Laguna for me was a huge breakthrough. It had a vacuum bed and it allowed me to start making templates and selling it to my audience in small doses. And that worked for a while. But then whenever it ramped up, in order to go to the next level, I now needed another machine. And so then I got into a Shopbot. It was just happenstance that I ran across a good opportunity to get into the Shopbot, and it has been all of my machines have been wonderful. So at this point, this is whenever I purchased the woodshed and was doing the renovation. My goal was to get all of the employees that I was hiring to work on these machines and process parts out of my personal shop so that I could retain my own space, but then also give them a shop to work out of. So during that timeline, that's whenever I purchased the woodshed and these machines came over here. Y'all probably know this about me, but I'm just not okay with just staying here. I wanna go here and I wanna go fast. I only had room for one more machine, at least at this point. And when considering what machine that was gonna be, I am very serious about production. And so I went with a Shop Saver. I believe every single machine on the market has its place, and I'm very fortunate to have the lineup that I have. But this one is a serious commercial unit that will absolutely take my business to the next level. One CNC machine is a business in its own. What it does is it automates a process that you would otherwise have to do manually over and over and over again. If you're a cabinet maker, for example, one of these machines is a business all in itself. Now, the Shop Saver machine automates even more processes than that machine does. Now that I'm trying to get to a higher level of a manufacturing shop, automating as many processes as possible is key. So let me get into a few things on what this machine does in order to help me there. One of the big obvious upgrades is that this does have a vacuum bed. The vacuum is actually stored at the rear of the machine on the ground. And of course, the Laguna machine that I have is also a vacuum bed. So I was already familiar about how much of an upgrade this is for the CNC. However, it's worth noting, listen to how quiet this machine is. This is with the vacuum pump and the spindle running. What the vacuum bed allows is there is a vacuum underneath that creates suction to suck down the spoil board as well as your material to the bed so that you don't have to have either tabs at all depending on how big or small the part is. Smaller parts like this, they definitely do need tabs, but we run lots of material that don't need tabs because it has a vacuum bed. One of the main struggles with CNC is figuring out how to hold down the material with the vacuum bed and just relying on that suction to pull it all the way down. It eliminates that completely. Then looking at the process, that also kills whenever I have to walk over to one of these other machines and go to every single one of the hold downs to tighten or untighten. It completely eliminates that step. Then taking it a step further, ShopSaver has automated the process of loading material even easier by having reference pins. They have a cordless pendant, which is also a really nice feature, but the reference pins are these. Tell me, that's not cool. That's like some space stuff. So what that will do is, one, you can take off the material, but then whenever you want to load it back, you pop up the pins and now you can reference your material all the way to the bottom and all the way to the left of the machine, making, if I wanted to cut 50 of these, then I can make sure that they're all in the same spot to do that. Just for the fun sake of it. Besides the vacuum bed, the biggest upgrade that I'm absolutely in love with that is a game changer to me is the automatic tool changer. Typically on a CNC, if you have a job, let's say I cut out a bunch of charts that first require an engraving bit, and then you come back with a regular end mill in order to do the profile to cut out the profile of the chart. You have to manually change over that bit from an engraving bit to the end mill and then back to the engraving bit for the next sheet. That process only takes, 45 seconds to a minute, but still that time counts. You can have 10 tools lined up here. Then whenever it's done doing all of the engraving, it will automatically come back here, release the engraving bit, pick up on the end mill, and then go immediately into the profile cutting. Another thing that the ATC eliminates is having to zero Z in between bit changes. So whenever you put in a new bit, it measures the height of it and then you Z it out. It'll remember that so that whenever it comes over and swaps out the engraving bit for the profile bit, it doesn't have to re-Z it at that point. It can just automatically go in and start cutting. Watch how ShopSaver has incorporated the dust dock. What this does is it removes the dust boot before it goes and picks up the new tool. This has been a real big point of frustration for CNC owners, so the fact that they've automated this is just really neat. By the way, I wanna address this noise real quick because it's actually a really cool feature. You have to hook up an air compressor to this unit and it's always dispensing a small amount of air in order to make sure that no dust gets up into the system. So that's why you're gonna hear that throughout this entire video. Now, in order to maximize precision, the ShopSaver unit is upgraded to this ball screw system here. And watching this thing work is just incredible. On most CNCs, I think all other CNCs, it uses a rack and pinion system. With a rack and pinion system, there's always gonna be at least a tiny bit of play, and this ball screw system completely eliminates that. All right, let's move up here, because I also think that this is a really cool feature. So, typically, one of the axes that you're most limited by is your Z axis. And on whenever I'm cutting fraction of decimal charts, for example, there is so much lettering. It does an A, it picks up and then goes down to the next letter. Then it picks up and goes down to the next level. And all of that Z up and down motion just makes the time it takes to cut an entire sheet incredibly long. Z is notoriously gonna be your slowest axis to work along because it's always gonna have to raise and lower the weight of the spindle head. What ShopSaver has done is they've included an air cylinder or an air piston that is calibrated to counterbalance the weight of that spindle head. And that way it can move up and down drastically increasing cut speed and therefore reducing runtime. One thing I'm really excited about is the ability to add a laser to the ShopSaver. So this is something made by Opt Lasers out of, I believe they're Polish, and they just mounts right here on the side of the ShopSaver, allowing me to very quickly go from not only the capabilities of a traditional CNC, but now having laser capabilities as well. This unit is a 6-watt unit that allows me to do some engraving passes, but note that they do also make a 15-watt unit that has a 3-laser diode blue engraving laser head. It can also engrave on steel or cut up to 3-millimeter plywood in one pass. there's quite a few different directions that I could get into for my CNC business, but I think to wrap it up, let me at least show you the workflow that we've figured out so far to work best for us. With the machines being here, facing them this way and being able to have rows in between them has been very, really valuable. All of the dust collection and the vacuum bed pumps are on that end of the CNCs. On this end, each one of the pedestal lives. A workbench, not for working on, but just for moving around material from the material racks to the beds and vice versa. The material is of course stored to where it's readily available to throw onto the machine, but is also forklift accessible. Whenever you're working in quantities of this scale, being able to maneuver things with a forklift is invaluable. Now moving over here, right next to the CNCs, is of course where the detabbing station is. It's gonna be the unit that's closest to the machines. Now we wanna try to start getting things away from the machines, which is where the inventory and the packaging up system goes. So that's been pretty much this station here. However, as things expand, which I'm hoping that they will, then we'll probably move that further away from this station where multiple people will always be working. Once packaging is done, we wheel big carts over to the shipping department where my mother is working to put a label on it. I spent years not having evenings or weekends because I was just on this mission to create something. Because at the root of it, I am still incredibly passionate about what it is that I'm doing. But to get to this point in my career to where now I have a full-fledged team supporting me to where I can not only take things to a different level, but I can also enjoy life at the same time. It's just an absolute incredible feeling. And if you've also been supporting me from afar and rooting me on, then I can't tell you how much I appreciate it. If you have a high production job that is on your radar that you're looking for a shop, then please consider me and my crew. We do work extremely hard and very proud of what we're achieving here. So that's it for this one. I really hope that you have found this video entertaining, informative, and hopefully useful. I'll see you on my next one, guys. Way to go, team! Get back to work!
I love it, yeah, right?
Real quick, I want to pause and thank this video sponsor, which is Keeps. Between coworkers, friends, and families, I have a lot of men in my life, and they all have one thing in common. They want to keep their hair. 2 out of 3 guys will experience some form of male pattern baldness by the time they're 35. And the best way to prevent hair loss is to do something about it while you have hair left. Keeps is a subscription service that makes it easier for men to treat their male pattern baldness. A licensed doctor will review your information online and recommend the right hair loss treatment plan for you. Then, your treatment is shipped directly to your door every 3 months. Keeps is affordable too, as they offer generic versions of FDA-approved hair loss medications. Treatments can take up to 4 to 6 months or more to start seeing results, so it's important to act fast. The sooner you start, the more hair you'll have. If you're ready to take action and prevent hair loss, you can go to keeps.com/April to get 50% off.